We're going to take a look at one of the neat built-in functions that comes with the Spike Prime Hub. When you first turn on the Hub, you'll notice that this little heart diagram pops up on the display. And what's really, really cool is that this is actually a function that allows you to control sensors and motors without actually needing to code anything. When you click into it, you'll notice that each one of the ports on the Hub is lit up. And when you plug something in, whether it be a motor or a sensor, there's a little bit more movement going on the display. The light seems to be traveling into the port with the motor and out of the port with the sensor, and that's because sensors send instructions whereas motors receive them. And what's great is if I were to take this sensor and plug it into the same adjacent port that the motor is attached to, now I have a way to control the motor. If I press down on the sensor, the motor starts spinning. You can use any of the three sensors in the kit to control the speed of any of the three motors. For example, the force sensor is great because you can control how much you press it, and that determines how fast the motor spins. The color sensor can also run the motor if it detects the color of any object, and the farther away you get from that object, the slower the motor will rotate. The distance sensor will also rotate the motor based on how close it gets to an object, but it is a little bit more fidgety because it has a range of up to 200 centimeters, so even if something's far away, it'll still detect it at times. You can run your motors in different directions based on which side of the hub they're attached to. The left side of the hub, ports A, C, and E, will run motors clockwise, while the right side of the hub, ports B, D, and F, will run motors counterclockwise. It's possible to attach multiple motors and sensors at the same time, and that's really what makes the heart program so great. It's the simplest, most convenient way to experiment with the different components that you have in the Spike Prime kit. And that way you can test out different things without having to program them. Like if you want to test out a specific build or see if something works with a motor, or maybe you just really, really want to make a small sensor-controlled car. And you can do all of these things without needing to actually program or code anything. If you do want to learn how to program the different components in the Spike kit, then definitely make sure to check out our other video tutorials where we break down the different sensors and motors in the kit and the different things that you can do with them.